Well, this has Justin Verlander written all over it for Houston. Another almost at the buzzer deal. How were other teams talked about it? How were the Astros the one, JP, able to pull this off?
Well, Chris, Jeff Luhnow, the Astros GM, actually made that exact comparison given the lateness of the deal. Final hour. How about the final 2 minutes? 3:58 p.m. Eastern time was when this deal got consummated. And in fact, Chris, Luhnow said they hadn't even talked up until 48 hours before the trade deadline. And the reason why it made sense here, two reasons actually. Number one, the Astros very creatively found a package of prospects the D-backs liked because of the future value. Corbin Martin, one of the key names there, actually just had Tommy John surgery, but Marquis, someone that they look at for the future there in Arizona. And the Astros, they were able to take on the salary. The D-backs included about a third of the $70 million left on Greinke's deal. But Houston's ability to pay, much like with Verlander, was the key deciding factor.
And they didn't give up their top two prospects, which was a key to the deal. So this has to make the Astros the team to beat for the World Series.
Now. Yeah, if you look at it, too, this is a team that already has experience, especially with that World Series championship 2 years ago. But now they understand the importance of starting rotation. And when you play the regular season, you might be able to manipulate that and wedge yourself around it. Now when you have the postseason, they know a formula is the starting rotation. So Zach Greinke is a huge reward when it comes down to this Houston Astros.
Are they
team.
Better, in your opinion, than the one that won the World Series?
I think they are. And the reason why I say this is that you're talking to A.J. Hinch, and you said he even said it, that room has changed. The reason why? Because he understands that with Verlander and with Gerrit Cole, they have a 1-2 punch. Now they have a third, and it's a mixture of what Zach Greinke can bring. It's the curveball, it's the changeup. He's a surgeon out there. He's a command guy that really changes the whole dynamic of the starting rotation and also gives confidence in that room, and that's a priority.
That's a great point, Mark. And also, I think the difference between this team in 2017 now is the lefty bat of Brantley. Much more balanced in the lineup. And let's not overlook the importance, possibly, of Aaron Sanchez. This is a former ERA champion in the American League. He is that good of an arm. Now, injuries have taken over there. He may actually start a game for the Astros as early as this weekend.
Yeah, and you look at Aaron Sanchez, this is the diamond in the rough because this is an all-star before, and now you're starting to try to create that difference, and you have him with a different pitching coach, but also experience in that rotation. Those conversations are imperative.
Yeah, and Houston was, as far as Greinke goes, not one of those teams on his no-trade list. His postseason record 3-4, but this Astro team, a little bit of a different deal, as you have pointed out.